If you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you, so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place.
They are from the second largest and second most populous continent. $7.16 trillion in measurable wealth. 1 billion people. Over 3,000 tribes, 54 sovereign states, one people. This is Dear Story. These are the tribes of Africa.
The Xhosa Nation are a Bantu ethnic group from southern Africa whose homeland is primarily within the modern-day Eastern Cape. There is a small but significant Xhosa-speaking community in Zimbabwe, and their language, isiXhosa, is recognized as a national language. The name Xhosa comes from that of a legendary leader and king called uXhosa. There is also a fringe theory that, in fact, the king's name, which has since been lost among the people, was not Xhosa, but that Xhosa was a name given to him by the San, which means fury or angry. Xhosa people refer to themselves as the amaXhosa and to their language as isiXhosa. The Xhosa people are divided into several tribes with related yet distinct heritages. The main tribes are the amaGcaleka, amaRharhabe, imiDange, imiDushane, and amaNdlambe. According to folklore, one of King Xhosa's descendants, Limfalo, gave birth to two sons, Gcaleka Kafalo, the heir, and Rarabe Kafalo, a son from the right-hand house. Rarabe was a great warrior and a man of great ability who was much loved by his father. Gcaleka was a meek and listless man. Gcaleka attempted to usurp the throne from his father, but Rarabe came to his father's aid, quelling the insurrection. With the blessing of his father, Rarabe left the great place and settled in the Amatholi Mountains. Rarabe, through his military prowess, subjugated various tribes he found in the region and would buy lands from the Khoikhoi and establish his own kingdom. The amaXhosa would from then on be split into two kingdoms under the senior amaGcaleka and the junior amaRharhabe. The key figure in the Xhosa oral tradition is the imbongi, or praise singer. Imbongi traditionally live close to the chief's great place. They accompany the chief on important occasions. The supreme being is called Utixo or Ukamata. In Xhosa tradition, the ancestors act as intermediaries between the living and God. They are honored in rituals in order to bring good fortune. Christian missionaries established outposts among the Xhosa in the 1820s, and the first Bible translation was in the mid-1850s, partially done by Henry Hare Dugmore. Xhosa did not convert in great numbers until the 20th century. One traditional ritual that is still regularly practiced is the manhood ritual, a secret rite that marks the transition from boyhood to manhood. After ritual circumcision, the initiates live in isolation for up to several weeks, often in the mountains. During the process of healing, they smear white clay on their bodies and observe numerous customs. Xhosa men traditionally fill the roles as hunters, warriors, and stockmen. Therefore, animal skin forms an important part of their traditional wear. Men often wear goatskin bags in which to carry essentials such as tobacco and a knife. Unmarried women often wear wraps tied around their shoulders, leaving their breasts exposed. Engaged women redden their plaited hair and let it screen their eyes. This was done as a sign of respect for their fiancés. Xhosa women wear some form of headdress to cover their heads as a sign of respect to the head of the family, which is either their father or husband. Elderly Xhosa women are allowed to wear more elaborate headpieces because of their seniority. The male intending to marry goes through ukutwala, which entails him choosing his future bride and making his intentions of marriage known. Decades before, it would entail legal bride abduction, where the man could choose a woman of his liking to be his bride and go into negotiations with the family of the bride without her knowledge or consent. Xhosa marriage rites include slaughtering of livestock to appease their ancestors. It also involves pouring a considerate amount of alcohol on the ground of the bride's household to give thanks to their ancestors. The groom's family is then welcomed into the family, and traditional beer known as unkombothi will be prepared for the groom's family as a token of appreciation from the bride's family. Xhosa is an agglutinative tonal language of the Bantu family. isiXhosa is spoken by about 18% of the South African population and has some mutual intelligibility with Zulu, especially Zulu spoken in urban areas. Many Xhosa speakers, particularly those living in urban areas, also speak Zulu and or Afrikaans and or English. The end.